expecting that we will bottom. Remember, we had 2.34 trillion naira to be borrowed to finance the 2017 budget. And when we are using it to finance the 2017 budget, we are going to use 22.75% of the amount, both the one we have borrowed and the ones we have generated, to service the existing debt, not to talk of the ones we have to borrow. And the budget also is based on non-oil, an assumption that non-oil revenue, which comprises of the company income tax, value-added tax, customs and excise duties, and federation account levies, will give us up to 1.373 trillion naira. And this 1.373 trillion naira will be generated from two major sources. One, independent revenue that will give us 807.57 billion, while various recoveries, which we don't know how much was recovered in 2016. In 2017, 565.1 billion will still be recovered from various sources. First of all, we don't know who the costs that we are recovering from are, and then we don't know how much we have recovered. So as to be able to know if this forecast is going to be sustainable, is going to be feasible. Now, here are some macroeconomic indicators between 2009 and 2015. And I want us to pay particular attention to the one we call variance between what is targeted and what was actually seen. Inflation rate. In 2015, we had inflation target of 9.55%, 8.0%, but we had actual inflation of 9.55%, which means what we experienced as inflation was higher than what we targeted. 2014, it was 7.5% target, and 7.98% was actual. It looks very minimal. The difference is not much, but that of 2015 is when we started having problems. And based on the top quarter statistics from National Bureau of Statistics, we can argue that for the forecast of 2016, we had over 7% variance between what was targeted and what was actual. Real GDP growth, we see almost the same scenario. Money supply, both M1 and M2, all of them have varying degrees of variance between the target and the actual. Now, we begin to ask, this 2017 budget, are there issues with it? Yes, there are. One of our moderators talked about zero-based budgeting. We are talking of zero-based budgeting on one side, and on the other hand, we are submitting enter by saying we have a three-year rolling plan. Then our enter is supposed to be built on what we have as a longer term plan, Vision 2020. After preparing the first national implementation plan that ended in 2013, nobody has talked about preparing the second implementation plan. And by right, we should have the second NIP for this Vision 2020 if we have not discarded the vision. And based on what we have as the second national implementation plan, we can easily draw our MTEP and even our AMRA budgets. But there was no second national implementation plan. The MTEP that was even prepared was just submitted, they have not been approved as at the time the 2017 budget was prepared and submitted. So there was no basis. Whether we could say on that note that 2017 budget is actually a zero-based budget, I don't know. So now the conclusion is that there is no foundation, there is no strong foundation for the 2017 MTN budget proposal. Budget may only serve the interest of some few. Number one, the creditors. Number two, the business as usual community. And I will explain. Why borrow at 20 to 30% interest rate to go and pay a 16, 20 to 30% interest rate loan that you have borrowed? You are borrowing from Mr. Paul to go and pay Mr. Peter. And you are still where you are, even worse off. So we have some creditors that are benefiting from the status quo.